Hello students, my name is Oliva Shah and it's your YouTube channel Physics with Oliva. Let's start today's problem. Four charges are arranged at the corners of the square ABCD as shown in the figure. The force on a positive charge capital Q kept at the center of the square. A positive charge capital Q is kept at the center of the square. You have to calculate the force on capital Q. Okay? Let's start. At first, see, connect this diagonal. This is the center where the Q is situated. So, if we are connecting the diagonal, then at the cross section, at the intersection point, we get the Q charge, right? Suppose this point is O point. Okay. Now, this minus 2Q, which is situated at A, is attracting the capital Q towards this. From Coulomb's law, we know that like charges repel and unlike charges attract along their joining line. Okay, so this is attracting, this is force due to the A. Okay, so I am writing it as 4FA, and this minus Q charge, which is situated at C, this is also attracting. This is FC. Okay. A, B, B, C, C, D, D, A. These sides are equal to A. Okay. AC is equal to A root 2. We know the length of the diagonal. And B, D is equal to A root 2. Okay. AO is half of AC. Right. So, AO is equals to A root 2 by 2. So, we can write it as A by root 2. Okay. And BO is also equals to A by root 2. So, from here we can calculate the magnitude of FA. That is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2Q into capital Q divided by the distance A by root 2 whole square. This is the magnitude of FA, right? This is, now calculate the magnitude of FC. That is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q capital Q divided by A by root 2 whole square. Among these two, we can see that FA, magnitude of FA is greater than magnitude of FC. So the resultant force, angle between them is 180 degree, right? So the resultant force between FA and FC is directed along the greater one. So the resultant force is directed along FA, right? So the resultant force among FA and FC is equals to, I am writing it as FR1, the first resultant. Okay, this is equals to FA square plus FC square plus 2FA FC cos 180 degree. So FA square plus FC square minus 2FAFC, as we know, cos 180 degree is equals to minus 1. So from here we get FA minus FC. This is the first resultant. This is the magnitude of the first resultant. So we know if we are taking common from FA and FC, that 4 pi epsilon naught A by root 2 whole square. Here we get 2q capital Q minus small q into capital Q, right? So from here we are writing that magnitude of FR1 equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by capital Q divided by A by root 2 whole square. This is the resultant force and this is the direction. This is the resultant force between FA and FC. The resultant of FA and FC is FR1, we get the magnitude and we also get the direction. Okay, now we will calculate the force FB and FT and we will calculate the resultant of FB and FT. Okay. Now, this Q charge which is situated at P point, this is also repelling the capital Q. So, this is the force, this is the repulsion force FB. And the 2Q charge which is situated at the point D, this is also repelling, right? This is the force FT. Now we will calculate F magnitude of FB and magnitude of FD. Magnitude of FB is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q into capital Q divided by A by root 2 whole square, and magnitude of FT is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2Q into capital Q divided by A by root 2 whole square. Okay, among these two, the magnitude of FD is greater than magnitude of FP and angle between them is 180 degree, right? So from here we can write the resultant among these two is equals to FD minus FB. Okay, so 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q capital Q divided by A by root 2 whole square. This is the magnitude of FR2. And what is the direction of FR2? Among FD and FB, which one is greater? FD is greater. So, the magnitude will be directed along this direction. Okay, suppose this is a box. You are pushing it with force FA and you are pushing it with force FB. And it is said that the magnitude of FB is greater than magnitude of FA. The ball will go in which direction? The ball will go along this direction with the resultant force FB minus FA. We are just doing these things. Okay. Now this is FR1 and this is FR2. We are denoting FR1 and FR2 by the blue arrows. Okay. Now we will calculate the resultant between FR1 and FR2. We will calculate the resultant of FR1 and FR2. This entire angle is equals to 360 degree. So, the angle between these two blue arrows, that is the angle between FR1 and FR2 is equals to 90 degree. Okay. So, the resultant force, the net force among FR1 and FR2 is equals to FR1 square plus FR2 square plus 2FR1 FR2. cos 90 means 0, so we will get root over FR1 square plus FR2 square. Now we can put the values, we can see the magnitude of FR1 and magnitude of FR2 are same, so we can write 2FR1 square, that is root 2FR1. FR1 means 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q capital Q divided by A by root 2 whole square, right? This is the net force. And what is the direction of the net force? This is the direction of the net force, right? Okay. We can make a parallelogram here. And this is the diagonal of the parallelogram. If we are making a parallelogram here, then this is the diagonal of the parallelogram, this is the red line. So this is the final resultant net force along this direction. So the final resultant net force is along perpendicular to the side AB. You can say that F net is perpendicular to AB, or you can say that F net is acting along DA, right? This is the final answer. Thank you everyone for watching the video. If you have any doubts from this problem or from any other problem, you can write it on the comment section. Thank you everyone for seeing. Please like, share and subscribe.